post. It's going to be dark within an hour or two. But I'm finally getting time to work on the photo, so I'm going to see if I can figure out why the car does not have power steering. I'm going to take the bumper off, just go through all the connections, maybe check the subframe bolt or the door panel bolt that I suspect is the issue. I'm going to check and see if I can see anything there. The plan is going to be to get the car up, all four wheels in the air. I'm going to take the bumper off and I'm going to strip the intake off so I can work there. Basically where we work, I'm going to put the box back in and just see if I can see something that's not the way it should be. Hopefully it's not the power steering rack that needs to be placed in, but we won't know until I strip and check. So let's get started. Out the dog pan mount, and as suspected, the bolt was too long. It went right through the subframe into the power steering rack, so this is going to be an extremely expensive fix. Let me quickly show you guys what I'm talking about. So I took the dog pan mount out, as you can see, and I put the bolt back in just to check, and there you can see it in the middle of the screen. The bolt went right through and hit the power steering rack, so that's it's quite a bummer. There you have it. That's extremely bad news. I need to find a new power steering rack. I believe it's an extremely expensive fix. I'll start filming for pricing tomorrow, but I suspect there goes my entire slick budget. But I've got no choice. It's a mistake. We live and we learn. That's it. There's not much that I can do to it at the moment, so I need to get that fixed, pick my head up and start driving this car so I can get the mileage on the clutch and sort out all the other small things. I must admit to you guys, I've been doing a bit of work off camera. I'm extremely busy with work, so I didn't have much time to film or to work on the car. I took the car to Sebastian. I had him take out the power steering rack. I located the new one this morning. It's currently Tuesday, so I got a new rack. It's back here in the car with me. I'm on my way to go drop it off, and then he'll get it fitted, and then hopefully the car will be back on the road. Maybe tomorrow would be Wednesday. Maybe I can have the car back tomorrow afternoon or so. So, fingers crossed, hoping that the new rack is in a good condition and that it's working. I got it for an absolute steal from someone who wrecked his car. I just got the car back from diesel doctor. At least the power steering is sorted. It feels so nice to be driving a normal car again. You may never ever in your life take power steering for granted until the day you drive a car that's non-power steered. It's an absolute disaster. So thanks a lot to the diesel doctor, and shout out to Sebastian. I'll put his Facebook details up in the description if any of you guys got some issues with your diesel cars. Actually, not only diesel cars, but any van car. They
do work on them, so I'll put their details up in the description box for you guys. They're based in Pretoria in Moot. I'm quickly going to take the car for wheel alignment now, because obviously with the power steering rack that was out and all the other things that was out, the wheel alignment is far off. So I'm going to stop by Tiger Wheel and Tyre and have them sort the alignment for me, and then at least I can drive the car. I'm extremely excited. I'm just gonna end the vlog here. It's been a super tiring week for me. I've been working crazy long hours. Probably gonna work Friday, Saturday, Sunday as well. It's currently Thursday night. So I'm probably gonna work right through. Anyways, you guys would have seen that I got the car back. Huge shout out to Sebastian from the Diesel Doctor. I'll have him linked down below. You guys can go and follow him. He got the car sorted for me perfectly fine. I thought I had an issue with the dog bone mount. He drove all the way to my house to come and check the car out. Turns out that it was just a bit of clutch shudder, which is apparently perfectly fine when you, or perfectly normal when you're bedding in the clutch. So at least the job that they did for me was perfect. No complaints. Next vlog you guys will be seeing will be of the Tiguan. I'll probably have that one on for you guys after the weekend, either Sunday or early next week. You guys wouldn't believe what happened with me on that car. It's terrible. I'm lost for words. I'm not gonna go into details. You guys will just have to wait and check the other vlog that's gonna come out on that. But anyways, that's gonna be it for me, guys. Peace out and reflect your passion.